So far we have discussed how to use the exponents while expanding the larger numbers, and we have seen that what is the base and exponent of a power. Then we have, now we will solve some problems based on all these concepts. Now find the value of 2 to the power of 6. So here in the first question, 2 raised to the power of 6 means here 2 is multiplied 6 times. Now let us write the product of 2 while taking 6 times. Now 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 8 2's are 16, 16 2's are 32, 32 2's are 64. So when 2 is multiplied 6 times, then we get the product 64. Now here 9 cube. 9 cubed means 9 is multiplied 3 times. So we get 9 into 9 into 9. So this equals to 9 9's are 81 and 81 9's are 729. Next, 11 squared or 11 raised to the power of 2. Now when 11 is multiplied 2 times, so 11 into 11, so this equals to 121. Next, 5 to the power of 4 means 5 raised to the power of 4. So when 5 is multiplied 4 times, so then we get 5 into 5 into 5 into 5. So this equals to 5 into 5, 25, 25 into 5, 125, and 125 into 5, 625. So we can find the value of any power with any base and any exponent. Next, express the following in the exponential notation. Here the product form is given, so we should write the exponential notation. So for this exponential notation, here 6 is multiplied 4 times, so we take the base 6 and 6 is raised to the power of 4, because 6 is multiplied 4 times, so we write 6 raised to the power of 4 or 4th power of 6. In this, 6 is the base and 4 is the exponent. Now next one, 5 into 5 into 7 into 7 into 7. So for this exponential notation, equals to 5 is multiplied 2 times, so we write 5 square, and 7 is multiplied 3 times, so we write 7 cube. So 5 raised to the power of 2 and into 7 raised to the power of 3. So here the exponent is 5, base is 5, exponent is 2, and in this base is 7 and exponent is 3. Next, A is multiplied 2 times, C is multiplied 2 times, and D is multiplied 4 times. So in this exponential notation, here A is multiplied 2 times, so we write A raised to the power of 2, and C also multiplied 2 times, so we write C raised to the power of 2, and D multiplied 4 times, so we write D to the power of 4. Here the bases are A, C and D, and the exponents are 2, 2 and 4. So this is the exponential notation of the given product. Now let us see the next question. Identify the greater number wherever possible in each of the following. So in each of the following problems, exponential notations are given. So by writing the product, means by finding the product, we should find out which number is greater. Now in the first question, 4 cube or 3 to the power of 4. So if you expand 4 cube, so then 4 into 4 into 4, so this equals to 4 4s are 16, 16 4s are 64. Then the second number, 3 to the power of 4. So this is exponential notation. If you write the expansion, so 3 is multiplied 4 times. So then we get 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. So this equals to 3 3s are 9, 9 3s are 27, 27 3s are 81. So when we compare the products 64 and 81, here 81 is greater. So therefore we can write that 3 to the power of 4, 3 raised to the power of 4 is greater. Now the second question, 5 cube or 3 raised to the power of 5. So when you take the first number 5 cube, if you write the expansion, 5 into 5 into 5, now this equals to 5 5 are 25 25 5 are 125. Then if you take 3 to the power of 5, 3 raised to the power of 5, so this equals to, here 3 is multiplied 5 times, so then if you expand this, 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, so here 3 is multiplied 5 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now 3 3s are 9, 9 3s are 27, 27 3s are 81, 81 3s are 243. So when we compare the products, so here 243 is greater, so we can write 243 is greater. So here 243 is same as 3 to the power of 5. So therefore 3 to the power of 5 is greater. Now if you take the third question, in the first number is 2 to the power of 10. So 2 to the power of 10 means 2 is multiplied 10 times. So 2 into 2 into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, 2 is multiplied 10 times. So when we multiply 2 10 times, we get the product 1024. Now let us see the product. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 16 2s are 32, 32 2s are 64, 64 2s are 128, 128 2s are 256, 256 2s are 512, 512 2s are 1024. So the product is 1024 when we take 2 to the power of 10. The next number is 10 squared. So 10 squared means 10 is multiplied 2 times. So 10 into 10. So this equals to 10 tens are 100. So when we compare these two numbers, 1024 is greater. So we can write 1024 is greater. So 1024 is same as 2 to the power of 10. So 2 to the power of 10 is greater. Now let us see the next question. Express each of the following as product of powers of the prime factors. Now we have to factorize each of the following numbers, then we should write the product of prime factors. Now the first question, 648. So if we factorize, so we should take only prime numbers. Now it is divisible by 2. 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8. So then we can take 2 1s are 2, 1 is left here 12. 2 6 are 12, 2 2 are 4, then again 2 table, 2 6 are, 2 8s are 16, 2 1s are 2. Now it is not divisible by 2 table, then we can take 3 table, 3 27s are 81, then 3 9s are 27, 3 3s are 9. So when you write 648 as the product of prime factors, so we get here 2 is multiplied 3 times, so we write 2 into 2 into 2 into, yeah, 3 is multiplied 4 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, so yeah, 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. So when 2 is multiplied 3 times, we write 2 raised to the power of 3 into, yeah, 3 is multiplied 4 times, so we write 3 raised to the power of 4. So yeah, 648 can be written as the product of the powers of the prime numbers. So we can write 2 power 3 into 3 to the power of 4. Now the next question, 540. Now if we factorize the given number 540, so then it is divisible by 2. We can write 2 2s are 4, then 1 is the remainder here 14, 2 7s are 14, and 2 zeros 0. So again we can take 2 table, 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6, 2 5s are 10. Now it is divisible by 3, so we can take 3 4s are 12 and 3 5s are 15. Then we can take again 3 table, 3 15s are 45, so 3 5s are 15. Now as 5 is the prime number, so we can stop here itself. Now 540 can be written as the product of all these prime factors. Here 2 is multiplied 2 times, 3 is multiplied 3 times, and 5 is taken only 1 time. So then we can write 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 5. So this equals to, when 2 is multiplied 2 times, we write 2 to the power of 2 into 3 to the power of 3, because 3 is multiplied 3 times into 5. So this is the exponential notation of the given number 540. Now the next question, 3600. Now when you factorize 3600, 2 ones are 2, 2 eights are 16, 0, 0, again 2 nines are 18, 0, 0, then again 2 fours are 8, 2 fives are 10, 0, so again 2 table, 2 twos are, 2 twos are 4, 2 fives are 10. Next, 225 is not divisible by 2, now we can take 3, so 3 sevens are 21, 3 fives are 15, 3 25 are 75. Now 25 is not divisible by 2, so we can take 5 table now. So 5 5 is 25. So as 5 is the prime number, we can stop here itself, the prime factorization. Now 3600 can be written as the product of all these prime factors. So yeah, 2 is multiplied 1, 2, 3, 4 times, and 3 is multiplied 2 times, 5 is also multiplied 2 times. So 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 2 is multiplied 4 times, 3 is multiplied 2 times, and 5 also multiplied 2 times, 5 into 5. So when 2 is multiplied 4 times, we write 2 to the power of 4 into 3 is multiplied 2 times, so we write 3 squared, and again 5 is multiplied 2 times, we write 5 squared. Now this is the exponential notation, means the product of the powers of the prime factors of the given number 3600.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.